I'm Rick Emerson. It is the story of Dave's killer bread. And dealing with bread, it is a story of appropriately biblical proportions. A story of redemption, a story of this product and how they all came together. Mr. Dave Dahl of Dave's Killer Bread, Outlook Portland, begins right now on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. There are, of course, many abominations in this world. Pestilence, war, famine, strife, social ills of all varieties. And, of course, the worst thing of all, white bread. Not the figurative Brady Bunch vampire weekend kind. I mean actual, literal white bread. Spongy, lifeless, formless, pointless, hardly worthy of being called bread at all. Now, at the other end of the spectrum, something that you may have purchased and enjoyed, something that, like 89% of all glorious things, comes from within the borders of Oregon. Today, we're going to find out about Dave's Killer Bread, and we're going to find out about the amazing story behind the man behind the bread. Let's welcome now to Outlook Portland, the mastermind, founder, the overlord of Dave's Killer Bread, Mr. Dave Dahl. Welcome to Outlook Portland, sir. How are you today?
Great to be here. Thank you.
I have to ask you first and foremost, to whatever extent there is one answer to this, what is the secret to making good bread? Because your bread is it's a world apart.
I would have to say it's honest passion that goes into it. It's really, really caring about making the best loaf of bread. That's probably the genesis of it. I've always loved these grainy textured breads with lots of seeds and things like that. And I think my bread just has more of the good stuff than any other bread.
I got to tell you, and I mean this in the best way, these loaves of bread weigh like 100 pounds. So I don't know if that's just the weight of magic that I'm feeling in there, or what is the most common mistake that people, because you go to the store and there's just this wall of bread, and you take something and it looks like it's got seeds or nuts or heft or whatever. Yeah. You take it home and it's just bland. It's lifeless most of the time. What's the mistake people make?
I think it comes back to that thing is the soul of the company. I mean, when you start thinking about cutting costs in a product instead of making the best product, I think that's usually the reason why you get a less than product like that. I know exactly what you mean. And the bread looks good, and it just isn't that good because, hey, it might have been great when grandma made it, you know, but, and it's like, wow, this great recipe I have. Oh, but we have to cut this, we have to cut this, we have to cut this because we can't sell it. We can't make this bread for that much money. So, you know, what we did is, when I made these breads, I wasn't thinking about money, and that's maybe a blessing. I was just thinking about making great bread, and when we got to the point where we realized we started doing cost analysis and things on it before we released it, that was when we realized we were going to sell this bread for more than any other bread that we knew.
You mentioned something about it was good when grandma made it, and I know that you have a compelling personal story. I know that your family, or at least your father, had been a baker, had been in the baking industry. You mentioned something interesting on your website, I think, where when you were growing up, there was this line where a change happened, where you had thought that what your dad did was kind of cool. You know, my dad's a baker, that's a cool way to make a living. You reached a certain age and it didn't seem so cool anymore, and you wanted to go a different way. Tell me about that change. Tell me about how that happened.
My childhood's kind of fuzzy, but my dad seemed like he had a lot of qualities that made him a man. And as a child, you know, you looked up to your father as the man. And he obviously did some really great stuff. He was a pioneer in the in this industry of whole grains, natural, you know, basically organic products. There was a lot of things about him that if you wanted to dwell, it was really easy to dwell on the negative aspects of him. I started doing that because I was having problems with myself and my faith and all the things that I had been taught. And I just got to a point maybe when I was 12 years old where I didn't really believe in anything anybody was telling me, especially my dad, because he would say one thing and it would be something else. And so that's, my dad was a really, but anyway, I'll let you ask me the next question.
Did you make a conscious effort to get as far away from that kind of behavior? In other words, if your father was one way or lived a certain way, you were gonna go to the other end of the spectrum?
Very much. And, you know, at first, it was just being different than my dad and doing, like my dad said he was overweight because he was a baker, and like a lot of bakers are overweight, you know. I would start seeing that about him, and I worked really hard on not being that. And I would work really hard on having a little bit more neatness to myself, and I didn't want to talk the way he did, and you know, all those things. So it definitely set me on a different path.
When we come back, we will pick up the thread of this story and we'll find out where your life took you. And it was a long and winding road, as the Beatles would say, that ended in the triumph that we see before us here. We are talking to Mr. Dave Dahl of Dave's Killer Bread. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there.